Oh no. Oh no, she was taking the bus too. I forgot about that. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. His eyes are shut, right? Oh my gosh, she walked right past him. Oh, oh my God. Hope you're doing well, and thank you so much for clicking on my video. You have no idea how much I appreciate it. Today, I'm going to be watching and giving my thoughts on episode 8 of the currently airing Korean drama series on Netflix called Hospital Playlist Season 2. All my current reactions, which include episodes 1 through 4, which got taken down by TVN and YouTube a few weeks ago, are up on my IGTV, on my Instagram, and currently I have a couple of the approved right now reactions, which I will link a playlist down below in the description. And those of you that are new to this channel, welcome. I hope you're doing well. Make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell to be notified when new videos are up. And those of you that have been along on this Hospital Playlist journey with me, we're gonna have some fun. I don't know about you, but I am very worried for Rosa, the mother. The preview did not bode well for what's going on with her memory and stuff. And I did read through the comments in my last video, and it seems that there were some other times even in season one where we saw her forgetfulness. And I guess I just forgot about it. So maybe I should go see a doctor. Just kidding. My memory's fine. I'm just a hot mess. I was just telling my boyfriend this morning, I noticed that the dryer was on, and I'm like, did you turn the dryer on? He's like, no, I'm pretty sure you did it. I'm like, oh, I think a ghost did it. Because I don't remember doing it. So maybe I should go see a doctor. But stress does weird things to your memory, let me just say. But with that weird intro, let's go ahead and get into the episode, and I'll give my thoughts at the end. Timestamps are below. Let's get started, shall we? Come on, don't lie to one another, you're friends. Oh, poor thing. Oh, she started a memory book. I learned this in Navarilla, where, you know, when you think you have Alzheimer's or something, you're supposed to kind of write down details in a book, mostly what you've done throughout the day, but poor thing. At least she's like kind of preparing herself. You'll just fart nonstop. Oh no, what's he gonna say? She's like, stop, don't do weird things. She thinks he's adorable. He wants to put him in his pocket. Oh, she went to a personal color analyst. She's a warm tone, warm spring tone. That's not your tone. Oh my God. It's just bad jokes all around this episode already. We're tight on time. She has no watch. That was a cool shot. I really like that. All right, she's finally checking in with him. Aw, he wants her to bring her to Eugene. She tripped and fell and hurt herself pretty badly. A broken rib and a few... I'm questioning that too. I think her dad did something. Aw, he's so worried about her. He's like, can I text you even if you don't text me back? Oh my gosh, he's so excited. Your friend Piggy number one, obviously. They're all freaking out about the order size. It's so well curated. A muggle like us. What's a muggle? Oh my gosh, I love the music. Oh my gosh. Who's Malfoy? Malfoy muggle. The new deputy director. That's why the name's so strange. God, at least he knew he was lying about that. It's a rookie boy group? He's messing with them too! Oh my God, these two. Okay, they finally did tell him what it was about. Harry is a hero! Wow, she's helping a lot of people with her thesis. Yeah. She's like there and ready. She's got her hair back. She's going for it. Oh, the fact that she's calling that it's going to be quiet tonight, it's probably going to be chaotic. Oh my gosh, patient related superstitions. Oh no, and she just did that, didn't she? And she ate the ice cream that they gave her, right? Am I understanding that? Oh. Called it. What's your bank account number? She's like, I have to pay you back. They'd like to transfer a patient to you, a PPH patient. Oh my gosh, there's so much blood. This is terrifying. Oh dear. This is giving me anxiety. Oh, she's so depressed and sad. I hope that she doesn't have Alzheimer's. Oh, she's too scared to see a doctor. Yeah, man. Oh, I'm having flashbacks to Navarella or Navarillo. Ooh. Oh my gosh, look at them. Just like watching this meat getting cooked. Their devotion to food. Oh my gosh, that looks good. Oh. Oh my gosh, he's gonna take the piece that they wanted. What is she doing? Is she looking for more meat? Is she assessing the grill? What is she doing over there? They got to go orders. Oh, he got to go orders. He's so sneaky. Oh, what's he seeing on her phone? I feel like he saw that she probably still has a picture of Junwan on there or something. Or maybe there was a photo of the London neighbor on the phone. What's going on there? She's trying to make herself feel better. Is she at her apartment? She's still at the hospital in one of those bunk beds. Why is she scolding this teddy bear? Yeah, you're awfully mature. Yeah, you're talking to a teddy bear girl. Oh my gosh, she's so cute. Is this the teddy bear she meant to give him on like the first episode of the season? I think it is. Yeah, she needs to ask him out again. Oh, she is. She's still at the hospital in the bunk beds. Oh, she totally got caught talking to herself, talking to the teddy bear. She heard at least three different people. And she's just pretending like it didn't happen. She is one crazy, silly lady. I love her so much. She just gets better and better each episode. Something else going on with Rosa? What's going on, Mama? You waking up in the middle of the night because you're in pain or something? What's happening? Why are you waking up? Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. She's like yelling, I'm really okay. You're not okay, Mama. Good for him. Yeah, turn around. And of course he called her son. Good. Oh, no. Look at her head. Oh. Yay, someone was there. She opened her eyes real fast. I think she was pretending to be asleep because she couldn't face her son. Oh my gosh, did I call it that it's not Alzheimer's, but like something else? Oh, please let it just be fixed with surgery. Okay, they're going to drain something? Okay, sorry, I had to self-soothe. Shunt surgery to move the extra CSF into the abdomen. Okay, this honestly makes me feel so much better. I know that this is still a surgery that's involving the brain, but it sounds like it's not Alzheimer's. And it sounds like there's ways to fix it. So she might be okay. Yay. And she's saying, according to the CT scan, it's not serious. She'll recover quickly if the surgery goes well. Oh, thank you. And now he's beating himself up because he feels like he didn't notice this before. Oh, look at the single tear coming down her face. Oh, man. Oh, this has got to make her feel so much better. Yeah, I must be the only one happy that she has that surgery too. No, family, don't cry. If you cry, I cry. What a strong mama. Oh. Jungwon, don't cry. Oh, God, I can't handle it. I think he's more upset that she thought she had Alzheimer's and didn't tell him. And he's upset with himself because, you know, he saw all these symptoms and didn't connect anything as a doctor. So he's got a lot of emotions running through him right now. And he's doing a great job portraying it. Freaking love it. That was a weird shot. It looked like they had the focus wrong. They had the focus on the flowers, but... Oh, I see what they're doing here, you know? Like, they have Rosa, who she's like, yeah, all the surgery I need, please, let's do it, I'm strong. And then we have these two other elderly patients that it's like, one's like, I think I'm too old to deal with this. She's like, I'm okay, let's go. We have the one with the heart stuff. 78, that's young. 70 is the new 50. Yeah, I'd say she's still very young. Aw, that's gotta make her feel better. He wants the surgery. So I'm thinking the theme here is older people getting slightly dangerous surgeries and maybe that it's okay if they want to have a surgery at that age. Oh, they're having a little powwow. This guy has a different set of priorities. That's where he's coming from, is the fact that all this is going to cost money. He's more concerned about the money, really, than the surgery. And it's like, if the surgery doesn't go well, we still have to pay her medical bills, and she's not going to be better. I think it's all money for him. Mom better not show up and hear this. That's going to be very upsetting. Oh, she was listening. No! Okay, good. So they've confirmed that it is the condition that they were saying. It's too long of a word for me to say. The Hydra something. Oh no. She's getting bad news about her mom. Parkinson's disease? Oh no. I didn't even think about her mom. And she was all complaining about how her mom's always getting checked out. Oh no! Oh dear. And she probably hasn't seen her mom as often as she should, so like she hasn't noticed. Oh my gosh. Well, that's some terrible news. I was so worried about Rosa, they got me. And I'm sure she's like, damn it, I should have been there for the meeting. She was all thinking it was gonna be fine, so she was like, look, I got surgery, Mama, I can't be there for you. Dang. Aw, she's immediately gonna go home. I feel like I need to go call my mom. Oh, don't cry! If you cry, I cry! Ikjun shows up just in the nick of time. They did this on purpose! Why would they do this to us? I guess, are we finally gonna meet her mom now? Or are they just gonna kind of leave that in the background? Oh, he's gonna give her a ride. Say yes! Say yes to the ride! Oh, my heart is breaking for her. I should have seen this coming. I was just all focused on Rosa. They got me. They got me. Oh, I forgot about this guy. Oh, I forgot she was their lucky charm. Ah, she's getting a loan to get money for her parents to upgrade their guest house. That's really sweet. What a good daughter. But is it? Because she's putting herself in debt for her parents. Maybe not. I don't know. Oh. Oh, she came to visit. Oh my gosh, what a surprise. Oh. Me, not him, right? What a surprise. He's shook too. He's like, what are you doing here? Well, that brought my spirits up. She's like chasing after them. She's just so happy. Yeah, because in the last episode, she was talking about how she really wanted to meet her, but she didn't want to cause like a whole situation since their relationship is, you know, still under wraps. And she didn't want it to be uncomfortable. Oh, how sweet. Now is she going to tell him what's going on with her mom? Surprise. Aw, she wanted to surprise him. Okay, so her mom's staying with her. This is all signs to me that her dad, like, pushed her down the stairs or something. I mean, the broken rib thing feels like a towel. Oh, is this the stop she was going to make? I hope it is. Because they just seem so down about it. Oh, look at him! Yep, his demeanor changes immediately, yeah. Oh, good, she is gonna be there. Aw, I'm sure that made him feel so much better. Oh, lady. You think he saw her through the door and was like, I'm changing my mind. She looks like she's not in the best of condition. Oh, okay. Ah, he's dealing with it. He's like outside her door. Oh, look at him handling it for his friend so she can have some alone time. He's like guarding the door. It's like, where are you going? What are you doing? It's like, wait. He is the gatekeeper. You can ask me. I know everything. He got her the skillet thing she was obsessed with at the restaurant. Oh, that actually does look really cool. She's so pumped. This like made her night. Oh, he's like so impressed with himself. Oh, I'm gonna cry with how happy she is about that stupid skillet. Oh, look at them all worried about her. Oh. Is he like, where are my snacks? Somebody's eating. I bet I know who it is. I bet it's Ikjun. You don't touch his snacks, bro. He's gonna go for the snacks 100%. Ah! I knew it! It's my only joy and happiness. Oh boy. I know how it feels. Oh my gosh. The hair pulling. Oh my gosh. Oh, that was great. And then they're back to normal with their hair all ruffled. It's so cute. So Ikjun always buys his tickets for him? Am I understanding that correctly? Funeral parlor. What's happening? Oh, what's going on? Oh, his friend of 30 years. Okay. Woo! I mean, that's terrible that his friend of 30 years died, but maybe this is going to change his perspective and, like, want his mom to live longer? I don't know, but that's terrible news. Yeah, he was only 50. I don't mean to laugh at the pain, just the fact that he's talking about age right now. I'm hoping that this sort of changes his perspective on his mom. They invited a stand-in. She's a busy lady and she's expensive. Could it be Rosa? Is it Rosa? Oh, it's Rosa. How sweet. Oh my gosh. This is the best guest keyboardist ever. Oh my gosh. Yes. I don't know if she really plays the piano, but this is so wholesome. Oh, why is this making me cry? Oh my gosh. I'm an emotional mess. He's looking at his mom. It's so sweet and wholesome. Oh, why is he having to apologize? Oh, no. One of them came. Oh, no. Yeon-suk Hyo. Oh. Oh, my gosh. He came. Who's the person standing next to you? She doesn't believe that he's there. She's so cute. Oh, she's such a baby. I love it. This response, I love it. Is she just so happy he's there? She's just so happy. She likes him so much. Oh my gosh, this is so funny. What a way to he's like kind of patting her, but patting the pillow, not her head. He's like trying not to laugh at the situation. He's so bad at this. Oh wow, he seems like he's so much better. Yay. Yeah, he seems better. He's standing better. He's not having trouble breathing. Okay, so she's going to go through with the surgery. Good, good. I mean, she's in the hospital bed. I should have sort of connected that, but needed her confirmation. Aw, he did have a change of heart. Good. He really does have Ikjun, like, book his train tickets. That's so weird. Or his bus tickets. I guess they're bus tickets, not train tickets. I wonder why I'm gonna have to rewatch that scene because I'm not 100% sure why it's so difficult for him. Oh no. Oh no, she was taking the bus too. I forgot about that. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. His eyes are shut, right? Oh my gosh, she walked right past him. Oh my god. Oh, did he sense her? Did he feel it? Does he know? His eyes were shut, weren't they? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Is it her? It is her. Oh my gosh. What? I forgot that from the beginning of this episode. Oh my gosh. Whoa. What a way to end that episode. Well, that was episode 8, and I gotta say, that ending. Whoa, what a cliffhanger. I am looking forward to see what comes out of that whole thing, especially after watching the preview for episode 9. Super excited for next week. And gotta say, this episode was so great. I'm glad that I was right, in a sense, about Rosa and that whole situation. But then they had to go and do that to Sungwa's mom, and I totally didn't even think about that. Especially since in the last episode when they were camping, she was totally talking about her mom, was just sort of brushing it off. And then come to find out, Parkinson's. So that's really terrible. And the fact that we haven't even met her mother, and I personally felt so bad for Sungwa and her character and everything, really well done. She's a great actor. It's like, we don't even have to meet this mother. We've only heard her voice to this point. And I was emotionally just so, I felt her pain. I feel like I need to call my mom after this. It's interesting, the dynamic there. You know, both of these doctors, they care for patients every day, all the time, yet they sort of disregarded both their parents' symptoms. You know, they noticed it, they commented on it, and neither of them connected that something could be wrong with their family members. I found that a very interesting dynamic there, which is very true. You know, when you're in it, you're in it, and you kind of forget to check on the people closest to you. I don't know if that was the lesson we were supposed to learn from this episode, but I kind of came away with that. And also that you're never too old. You should want to live as long as you want. You know, we had a lot of elderly patients for sure in this episode, and all of them came out fine from their surgeries, which is really good, especially Rosa. And that scene of her playing with the band, oh, so cute. And the reason why, that was great too. Rosa also got to meet Jungwon's girlfriend, played by Hyun Bin, who obviously she has been out of the office taking care of her mother, and she still has not given a good explanation as to what happened to her mother, just that she had to have emergency surgery, she had broken ribs. All that leads me to believe that there was some sort of struggle. I mean, broken ribs, that's like a huge tell. So the fact that she still has yet to tell him, that aspect is really worrying me. And Ik Jun standing guard in front of Sungwa's office after her mother's diagnosis and just sort of gatekeeping, like he doesn't have anything better to do. You know, he is a doctor with so many surgeries on his plate, and he takes this time. And then bringing her that gift of the skillet, I could not handle it. I thought that was just so sweet. Obviously, they are the best non-couple ever, and he really knows her, and I think that their friendship is perfect. I wish they would be together, but you know what? I think I'm just gonna have to face facts that they're just the best of friends, and even if he wants more, he's happy with what they have. The writing was impeccable as usual. There were some really fantastic camera movements, like really great cinematic shots done. They do amazing work in every episode. We've seen in past episodes, you know, looking at the doctors as they're looking at the computer screen, through the computer screen. That's really cool when they shot those. And the band shots were pretty simple, except for until they did the kind of slow punch in on the phone recording the band. I thought that was really well done. And they do a really good job of the rule of thirds in this show. Everything's very left-right. Not a lot of centered shots, which I actually really enjoy. I think it adds another dynamic to the show, the cinematography. I freaking love this show. I don't know if you know that. I love it. It was a cute episode. Absolutely cute. I didn't technically cry. I definitely teared up, especially when Jungwon's mom was in the hospital and, you know, him finding out that she was thinking that she had Alzheimer's, and you know, he was just feeling really guilty and really bad for noticing her forgetfulness and her stumbling and stuff, but not really thinking anything of it. You know, he was feeling like a terrible son. You could tell he was angry at the fact that she was trying to hide it and didn't want to talk about it, and for the fact that he had been kind of ignoring it. You know, he wasn't connecting the dots even though he was a doctor. I know how that feels, you know, and I mentioned that whole connection earlier in this review. So I think that's all I have to say about this episode. Let me know your favorite parts of it in the comments below. And what are your theories going on in the next episode, especially with how this episode ended? That was whoa. Especially because Ik-jun was the one getting his ticket. Like, and he even had that conversation with his sister at the beginning of the episode. So was that on purpose? I don't think it was on purpose, but it is quite a coincidence. So very curious to see how that's gonna turn out. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a like and share it with your other K-drama loving friends who happen to also be watching this show. And make sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell to be notified when new videos are up. I post weekly most of the time. And we are getting close-ish to the end of this series, so let me know what dramas you see coming your way that you're excited about, that you're interested in watching. I saw Hometown Cha-Cha-Cha is coming out the 28th of this month, and that looks pretty interesting to me. I love the main leads that are gonna be in it, so let me know what you guys are looking forward to. I'm looking for a new one to react to coming up, so I would love your suggestions. Until next time, thank you so much for watching. I hope you're staying safe out there and making good choices, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!